Because there are things in the golden path that we voted against as a group 2 years ago. One of those is the new youth zone. And again, it's chicken and egg. I need to see, as Councillor Meaton was saying, wait for tomorrow night's surprise, is that you need to see how the council will deal with some of the issues that have been causing concern the residents. Whether it's the youth zone and the risk of denuding youth services in the outer areas, whether it's the country parks and the risk of perhaps cluttering up side streets in those areas or adjacent roads for parking diverted because people may not wish to use the paid parking fees. I was very interested in the debate about the area of Fort Schrock at the recent scrutiny committee, and they're clearly areas that members are looking at very carefully. I want to turn again to other things I mentioned in the notice of motion. Crossing patrols. Well, in one of the documents produced from the Chief Executive Saving, it said how unfortunate it was that the schools didn't follow the scheme that was proposed last year when the council wished to take money out of the schools budget from the schools and encourage them to pay for their crossing patrols. So yes, there are things that we are awaiting the outcome of tomorrow night to see what might happen. But we're told that this is a rehash, that there are some new elements in it, but it continues in the same light as previous plans, plans we've talked about the needs and concerns of the vulnerable. So whilst we're criticised for it, it is actually a statement from us saying, well, the proof of the pudding is in the eating, or whatever the saying is, that when we see how some of the decisions you're reaching in practice actually will bear on some of the fine sounding words in this plan, whether those are mirrored in what actually happens tomorrow night or in future months. And as a number of members here have mentioned libraries, then over the work done by that scrutiny committee and since then, various new data or costings for libraries like Barbara have emerged. So we're really waiting to see whether the communities, what the communities have said, is reflected in what happens tomorrow night. And you might say it's a chicken and egg, or I might say the plan needs to be in place and let's follow it. But there are clearly areas in the plan where there is some scope for manoeuvre. So we shall watch and see, but I think that it's inappropriate to vote for it while it's still being debated, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Gilchrist. The matter is now up for debate. Just remind speakers who will speak now on that 3 minutes. So if you follow our partners in the Youth Parliament and keep the time, that can be really helpful. Are there any other speakers on this debate?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I wasn't going to say much about this particular item, but I felt sorry for the fellow gentleman, even his own colleague from my government supported. But having had a chance to have a look at this particular corporate, I'll call it a plan, looks to me like a rather bland wish list, to be honest, because there's no dates by which anything will be completed. There's no methodology about how any of this should be delivered. I think even the finance people just talk about how we work, don't talk about how what resources are being put behind any of these particular priorities that the leader has talked about. So call that a plan is a bit of a misnomer, I think, and I can't see how anyone could support something that pretends to be a plan that has no time delivery methodologies, whatever. In the back we actually look at what finance section says, it talks about how to just get the right particular wording for you. Delivery programs, of course. Delivering the different things, assessing the best means of delivering the service due to the most efficient and best function. Managing demand, income, but it doesn't talk about when, how, which services. And again, I have to tell you, in terms of this administration's record on delivering complicated programs or even some straightforward projects, it is not great. In fact, last time I spoke to you about that, this whole panoply of projects that they were putting forward, they had to turn it into a, but there was too many, it had to be reduced down to a number. They had to wait to pay a lot of money to external consultants before they agreed. Then we had the big shared services project, that shared services was going to be the answer. This is where all solutions come. And guess what? It didn't actually materialise. But what we talked a little earlier in terms of answering the question. So it strikes me, Mr. Mayor, that this is not in the plan wish list. I don't think it excites anyone, but I can never quite tell if Bill would be excited or not. But in terms of I think climate even vaguely excited, I thought yet again it was an opportunity missed. And I think it's whilst I'm quite happy to support the amendment would by the Lib Dems, it seems very cogent about our plans.
Thank you. I think it's a shame that Jeff has dismissed this document. I think it does set out a cogent and case for the agenda next year. I do think it is a worth endorsing. I kind of despair a little bit, really. I gave Phil, Ben Castle-Gilchrist, the chance to tell us what savings he's in favour of. And yet again, he failed to tell us anything that he's in favour of in terms of savings. And I just wonder when the Lib Dems will actually... And Councillor Kelly, of course, is the worst of bet on this. Consistently, Stuart will trot out lies against everything they were putting forward and never offers them any alternative. And, Phil Gilchrist talks about the offered to make representations to government. Can I just remind the Council, Mr. Mayor, that the Autumn Statement last week, the Lib Dems signed up to £54 billion worth of cuts in public spending in the next Parliament. £54 billion. £4 billion in local governments. £4.8 billion in business, innovation and skills. £4.2 billion in education. That's what the Lib Dems have signed up to. And it's as if the Lib Dems in this chamber are not part of their party nationally. Because this is the reality of Lib Dems in power. And finally, Mr. Mayor, I really do take exception to Dame Mitchell's comment that we're all in the same boat. We all do things the same. Well, frankly, Mr. Mayor, we will not do things the same. And it's about time we start having some firmness in the way these decisions are made and stop discriminating against councils like Wirral with high levels of deprivation. And the Lib Dems should hang their head in shame that they're part of this agenda. Mr. Mayor, I ask Council to dismiss this amendment, support the corporate plan. Thank you.
Any against, just for form, one abstention, that's me. Okay, now
moving on to item C, which is the 7C, which is the proposed merger of Wirral and Liverpool Colliners Areas and Colliners Services. And I'd like to leave the council to move this.
Probably move this,
and seconded. Okay. All those in favour of this policy, please show. Okay, and with one abstention, that's all. Two abstentions. Okay. Okay, move on to. Sorry, is anybody against? No. Now then, just record the abstentions, myself and Councillor Cleary for the records.
Mr. Mayor, I think you've been a pleasure to have
that. That's all right. I take help from anyone. Okay, move on. Item D, which is happens on the 6th of November. If I could leave to move approval of this.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
And assuming we need a seconder. And okay, saying all the follows. So if there's any votes against? Councillor Freely? Just Councillor Mark, I've got you. It does say any votes. I've got this right. We need to take those in favour of this. Okay, it's fine. There's a mistake in there. Can I take those in favour of this, please show?
Seth. Referendum Council, not dissimilar in size, will pay £152,000. So clearly, this affair, we are behind the curve in terms of having a competitive salary. And, it is, I'm sure I don't need to tell Council how important it is that we get a world-class candidate for this job. You need to have a salary and a package that attracts the best and retains the best. It is not an easy thing to move in these times of austerity, I know, but I want the absolute best for Wirral Council because I believe our residents deserve the best in terms of the top person at the, in the organisation. The point Mr. Mayor made by the Dems, their member, the comparisons with other authorities, should look at the period of the financial climate and within which their chief execs to go up their posts. I believe does miss the point. The people who know the market, who know the recruitment constraints at the moment, are advising us that we need to up our salary. And if anybody has looked at the pages of the government press at the moment, in the jobs pages, you'll see a number of other authorities at the moment recruiting chief executives. So it is a very competitive market. And I do, Mr. Mayor, understand those who say this is a huge amount of money and it's difficult to swallow given the financial challenges that we've got. I would merely say that we do need to recruit